church. And I'm going to turn that off. I want to welcome you all to Community United Methodist Church. My name is Emily Beltran. I'm the administrative assistant here slash part-time youth volunteer slash part-time anything you need me to be. Today is Youth Sunday. The youth have worked so hard to put on this service for y'all, and so I want to introduce Maddox. He will be doing our opening prayer and telling y'all about the announcements, what's going on at the church.
Lord, I lift up this church this morning so that we may be blessed by you. Please reveal yourself so that we can rely on the Holy Spirit for guidance and direction as we face challenges every day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
The altar flowers are dedicated in the youth's honor. If you'd like to sign up for altar flowers, there's stuff in the back. Tomorrow at 5:30 is our community dinner at in the warehouse. Tomorrow at 5:30 p.m. Sorry. Tomorrow at 7 o'clock p.m. at Gateway Church, there will be a Martin Luther King Jr. celebration sponsored by Lincoln County Mescalero Minstrel Alliance.
Singing glory.
So, man, I just love that song. I don't know about you guys. Just knowing that, you know, whatever wall we put up, he's going to tear down to get to us. And so one of the books I'm reading right now is with John Revere, and he's talking about the desert. So if I could ask, and then just by a raise of hand, who feels like they're going through a desert season? These are the people I want to pray for. All right, a couple. So if everyone can bow their head real quick, we're going to talk about this desert. Oh, sit down, sorry. Sit down and bow your head. Dear Lord, once again, there's just so much to be happy for. I mean, we're getting through COVID. But at the same time, just the emotional tolls and things that we went through during COVID has not left us. There's still some kind of shadow looming over certain people. There's so many fragments in our community that we as a congregation need to put back together. God, I pray for the power, just, you know, someone sees some kind of wrongdoing, someone sees something wrong with somebody else, whether it's their brother, their neighbor, or even someone they don't know. I just pray that you give them the minds and the willpower and the spiritual belief of what you have given them to overcome that and just say, hey, I'm here for you. As a Christian, as me as a person, and I'm here for you. So God, I don't know who needs to hear this. I don't know who needs to be empowered, God. I just pray that whoever's going through something in their life, whether, you know, it's a huge desert or if it's something minor and minute, that you just give them the power to overcome, God. And I don't care what kind of lies they tell themselves, saying that they're not worthy, they're not, you know, they're not capable of doing whatever, because they are, because we are all children of God. And so I just pray that you give us the power to overcome. So God, as we go into this second song, I just hope that you can give them the power just to connect with you, God. I pray that whatever Holy Spirit needs to be released on these people can. And I just pray that whatever, you know, words trigger them, I hope that they can just sing it with their absolute might. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
If everyone can stand for the second song.
the Apostles' Creed.
Y'all can sit. I'm getting there, guys. I'm getting there. So one of the things I've come up to talk to you about today was our youth. Just talking about some of the miraculous things that are going on and some of the things that we're going to be doing. So to start that, I just want to say that our youth, man, just can y'all give them a round of applause? Once again, with COVID and just everything that's been going on, it's just like you never know exactly who you're going to be getting and when they're going to be coming, you know. So just having them here today and doing what they're doing is just a miracle, in my opinion. And so one of the things that I'm going to be talking to you today is about our mission that we're going to be doing this summer. So to kind of go into that, I'm going to show y'all a brief video.
Time. How do you spend it? How we spend our time determines who we are and who we're going to become. And I don't know about you, but I want to be somebody who loves. And this is why we created Next Step, to help young people become the person God wants them to be. But let me take a step back for a moment. What is Next Step? We mobilize thousands of young people to serve around the world. Our goal is for you to grow closer to God by working and serving alongside people from different cities, countries, and cultures. We do that through short-term mission trips, but our impact is anything but short-term. We partner with communities throughout the year, supporting local organizations and leaders as they determine the best way to meet their needs in their community. When you come on a Next Step mission trip, expect a life-changing week filled with meaningful and challenging work projects. Whether you're building a house, shingling a new roof, serving meals at a local food pantry, or spending time with these crazy little kiddos, you'll be making a real difference in these communities. Every night, you'll rock out with dozens of other students as our live bands lead you through powerful worship. We team up with amazing speakers and authors like Bob Goff and Francis Chan to create original films that challenge and encourage you in your faith journey. These evening experiences are designed to get you thinking and talking about your personal relationship with Christ. And at the end of the week, you'll be able to take a day to explore all the awesome adventures your community has to offer. You could be hanging out on the beach or rafting down a river. No matter what, you'll be having fun. And by the time you return home, you won't be the same person that left. And to support you on that journey, we've created a ton of additional resources to inspire and help you connect with God. We continually see young lives change on these trips, but don't just take our word for it.
This is actually my fifth mission trip with Next Step, and I've worked with everything from inner city Milwaukee to Pine Ridge in South Dakota, where we worked with the Native American Reserve there. And so every experience is amazing, and everyone is different in its own way, but everyone has impacted my life like so much.
It's been really great. I always tell people that Next Step is awesome. It's really cool to see people from all over the country come together for one purpose, to uplift a community and to bring light and empower people. I think that is great.
Next Step is fantastic. All mission organizations have goals that they set to be Christ-centered and servant leadership oriented and fun. Next Step lives out those goals better than any other organization that I've seen for short-term summer mission trips.
You brought in comfort for me, and I'm very grateful.
So what are you waiting for? How do you spend your time? Who's the person you're becoming? Join us on a Next Step mission trip this summer and discover the person God wants you to be.
So Emily was actually the one that kind of told me about this opportunity. In the past, she herself has gone on a couple of Next Step ministry opportunities, so she was just saying, like, I was like, man, I really want our youth to get more involved in different communities, that way they can see what's going on in, you know, different parts of the world. And so we chose Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, and because, once again, it's not too far from here, but yet, watching some of the travesties that's going on over there, and just seeing what us as Christians can help with, you know, because it's easy to say, oh, let's go on a mission trip, and let's go out of state, that's awesome, and, you know, power to people that do that, but sometimes it's more real to see something that's going on in, you know, right across the block from me. So with us doing this, we're just trying to see what's going on in our community and seeing how maybe we could potentially do something and move that closer to home. So once again, this is what I'm excited for with our youth, and I'm excited for us to have this opportunity. So we're going to go into scripture reading, and we'll give her some time to get up here, but it'll be presented by Savannah. So everyone give Savannah a round of applause.
And you be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened or dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Bow your heads one more time. I gratefully thank you, O living and eternal King, for you have returned my soul within me with compassion. Abundant is your faithfulness.
So I promised Justin during summer camp that I'd preach my next sermon without shoes on. Because he was preaching his sermon and he wasn't wearing shoes. I asked him why. And he said, because it brings you closer and you can feel everything. So Aaron and my mom are passing out Jenga blocks, or someone, Maddox, I like. Maddox is passing out Jenga blocks. These blocks are to represent your burdens. I want you to think about all your burdens and prayerfully focus them all into that block. They can be big, they can be small, but just put them in that block. especially as a teenager. We now, because there's so much pressure to look a certain way or to act a certain way, that we just keep piling up burdens like there will be no consequences. But at the end of the day, when you go home and let your true self out, it's broken and hurting because of all the burdens and society's expectations. You may sometimes be hating yourself because you're letting people get to you. Do you even think about God? Do you know how your faith can help you? In Joshua 1:9, it says, "I hereby command you, be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened or dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Do not be frightened or dismayed, because the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. He is there. He sees you and your burdens, and he sees you piling and piling them on yourself. And are you letting him help? Are you showing your burdens to God and saying, 'Hey, God, these are getting a little heavy. Do you think you can help me with a few?' Or are you just saying, 'No, I got it. I can handle it. I got this.' Because I guarantee you, you can't. Because tomorrow, you're going to go back into the world, put your facade back on, that everything is cool, and just start the cycle back over again. So can you handle the burdens of today? I know I couldn't, and if you can let me, and if you can, let me know, because we need to get you to a news station. But isn't that another thing? Everything you see on TV, or the news, or on social media, or on this thing, is negative, and is meant to scare you and put another burden on you. So they won't want to have the segment, this just in, a person in Rio Doso, New Mexico, has figured out how to live burden-free. Let's go to the source. Connor, to you." No, they aren't going to have that, because that's not what they want to keep you scared. They want to keep you scared. But that's the thing, that's why I'm up here, to tell you that you don't have to be scared. You don't have to be worried or overloaded with burdens. God is with you every step of the way, just waiting for you to say, "Hey, these are pretty heavy. Can you help me?" It is written so many times in so many ways. John 16:24, "Until now you have not asked for anything in my name. Ask and you will receive, and your joy will be complete." God wants to help you, and he will. All you have to do is ask. 1 Peter 5:7, "Cast all your anxiety on him, because he cares for you." Just another way to say that he cares for you and he wants to help you. Luke 11:10, "For everyone who asks receives, that one who seeks finds, and to the one who knocks, the door will be opened." He's going to help you. It might not be in the way you're thinking, but he's going to help you. And in John 5:14-15, "This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. And if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have what we ask of him." Again, he may not help you as you see fit, which can be seen in our favorite prophet Habakkuk, but that's a story for another time. He's going to help you because you're his child. As stated in 1 Peter 5:7, "Cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you." When things become too overwhelming, do we not finally give in and seek help? Help from our families, friends, clergy, but we often forget that God is there for us and caring for us all the time. We must remember the words of Jesus, written in Matthew 19:26. "With man, this is possible, but with God, all things are possible." God is our strength, and when we remember this and use the power of prayer, of all things are possible. So now that you've heard my plea, I'm going to pray over you, and if you see fit, you don't have to, but I recommend it. You take your Jenga block, which is all your burdens, and I want you to come up here and set them on the altar, give them to God, and pray for his love and help. You can stay up here however long you would like, but I just set those burdens and give them to God, because he can help you, and he will. So let me bow your heads and pray, and if you feel comfortable, come up. No matter what burden I'm carrying, I can trust that I will not only listen, but you will be also faithful and righteous as you answer. Sometimes my burdens are heavy and difficult as I lay them at your feet with loud frustration. Other times I may not be able to speak, but only utter pleas that have no words. Please give me courage and strength during these times so that I am able to lay down the burden and walk away, knowing that you will handle it as you have promised. Amen. As our last song plays, you can come up here, set your burden to God, and pray for his help, because he will help you. But if you'll please stand as the last song plays. Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe. You guard our souls and carry us through the troubles of life. So go and spread his good news to the world. Thank you guys for